Hi everybody, Tim Bartz here, your Ford Video Guy, with a little video here. As you can see from the title, this video is mainly about the off-roading we did at Tuttle Creek OHV. So we're gonna get into this video and some of the adventures we had and some of the mishaps we had there. But first, I want to talk about some things that I just got in the mail that you can expect for future videos. Okay, first, I wanted to kind of talk about this. We did get a soft shackle, so we do have that winch. And I thought, you know what? If I ever need to use that, I'm going to need a soft shackle probably. So we got this. This is Bubba Rope. Recommended by an off-rodeo with Brian and Melissa Clark. They recommended this here, so Bubba Rope. So we got theirs right there, soft shackle. And we also did get a recovery tree saver strap. I actually saw one at Harbor Freight, but it was a different brand, Badlands brand, and I don't have their winch, so I thought, you know what, I'm gonna get one online, Rhino USA off of Amazon. I got that. I'm not gonna open this up, but it basically goes around the tree and you connect your winch to the ends around the after you wrap it around the tree. That helps save the tree and not scratch it up, which is kind of a little weird because we actually damaged a tree on the trail, but not because we were winching, but because we got in an area where it was a little narrow and didn't realize it, and we kind of got a little damage on the Bronco. I'll show you later. Actually, probably see it in the video. No, actually, I don't have that in the video. So you'll see it here in just a little bit. I'll show you what happened, and I didn't even realize we hit the tree. So, you know, I am all about treading lightly and everything on the trail, and but when you're stuck, you're stuck. That's just kind of the way it is, right? So anyway, but back to the things we got in. So we got this from Mountains to Metal. I went to Bronco Supercell Tennessee and Mountains to Metal booth, and I just fell in love with this attic tray, and so we ordered it. It is here. So kind of unboxing it here so you can kind of see what's all in here. And so there you go. So they don't really have much of an install video, but I did watch somebody else that did install one. Take this a little wider. And it doesn't look like it'll be too difficult to install. I hope it gave me some instructions. There's a couple brackets in here, but this tray here, that is the tray right there that'll sit at the top. And then when I release it down, it'll kind of set almost level with the roll bars in the back. And my Bronco does have the holes that it needs for this. So if you have an early 21, yours may not have the holes in the roll bar. Ours does. So actually, let's go to the Bronco and check it out. So still got all the mud and everything from Tuttle Creek. This is in the middle of the week after Memorial Day, which from the footage you're going to see later is how we got all this mud on this. You're going to kind of see some of that. But I think, did I lock this back up? I think I locked it back up. You'll also see that this happened. Now you won't be able to tell in the video because it's just the front camera stuff. But I don't know what we got in there because I did not hear anything hit it. But there we go. We got a little damage on the Bronco. So it's, as Barb says, it's no longer a pavement princess. So I'm probably not going to get that repaired, but as you can see, it kind of goes from there up to there. So this is one piece. So I should be able to, if I want to, just change that out. Of course, I'll need it painted and put it in. I also need a windshield because I got a crack at the bottom. I think everybody's gotten a crack in windshield at some point on these Broncos, but I have that as well. But that wasn't from our trip. Anyway, let me unlock the vehicle here and show you what you need. Still love this thing, by the way. IAG, that's pretty cool. Got the struts replaced. You'll probably in a previous video see that. Not too difficult to get those replaced. And if you have any issues with IAG parts, you just call them, let them know you're having issues with it. They'll send you out new parts. They are really good in that. But this is these here. If you have an early 21, you want to make sure you have these spots. These actually have screw holes in there. So you'll need them for the side as well as the top two. And they use those to mount that on there. So you'll need that mount. And then I think they also mount on the top, but you'll need these here. So these are the ones that you need to make sure you have. So if you have an early 21, check and see if you have this before you order the attic tray. Because otherwise it won't work on your Bronco. You'll have to drill holes and such. So there you go. All right, that's all I have. Enjoy some of the footage that we have from down there, the GoPro as well as the dash cam footage from off-roading down there at Tuttle Creek OHV. And if you are going there with your Bronco, just make sure you know which some of those trails when you get down into those trees. I would stay away from them if you're in a Bronco. Most of them are made for side-by-sides, mainly. So, but you can have some fun down there. There are a few trails and some of the ones up on the top, and there's some rocks and some different things that are fun. We did have a lot of fun, so you can too as well there. So there you go. We will go there again. So, all right, that's all I have. Guys, have enjoy this video. We'll be right back.
me here at heaven's door, a place I've been so many times before. Familiar thoughts and phrases start to flow and carry me to places that I know so well. But dare I go where I don't understand? And do I dare remember where I am? I stand before the great eternal throne, the one that God himself is seated on. And I've been invited as a son. Oh, I've been invited to come and believe the unbelievable, receive the inconceivable, and see beyond my wildest imaginations. Lord, I come with great expectations. So wake the hope that slumbers in my soul, stir the fire inside and make it grow. I'm trusting in a love that has no end. The savior of this world has called me friend, and I have been invited with the sun.
can be found. And like the rain, I have been carried here to where the river flows. Yeah. My heart is racing and my knees are weak as I walk to the edge. I know there is no turning back once my feet have left the ledge. And in the rush, I hear a voice, it's telling me it's time to take the leap of faith. So here I go. I'm diving in.
Go. I hope you guys enjoyed that footage from the Tuttle Creek OHV here in Kansas. It's Randolph, Kansas, right by Tuttle Creek. I don't know if they consider a lake, but in close to Milford Lake. It's about a 15-20 minute drive from Manhattan, Kansas. So hopefully you guys, if you're in the area, you want looking for something, just beware, be cautious of some of those trails because some of them are a little narrow. So if you're looking to do that with your Bronco, don't get in the jam like we did and get stuck and get a little bit of damage on your Bronco. But know which trails are the ones that are good for that. So, but if you get some side-by-sides, you have a lot of fun out there. There are a lot of people who had fun that day. So anyway, I digress. That's all I have. Thank you guys for watching. And don't forget, in the future videos, we're going to be installing the attic tray from Mountains to Metal. Looking forward to that. We're going to be able to stow a lot of things on top of there. That'll be fun. And also, we'll see what else we have coming forward. I don't know what else we'll get into. Maybe go do a little camping as well. So hopefully you guys look for those future videos. Until then, stay positive, be kind to one another, be kind to yourself, and we'll see you later.